Denis Mukwege, a Congolese gynecologist and one of the few African leaders to be awarded a Nobel Peace Prize, one of the most prestigious and esteemed awards rewarded to the most influential philanthropists to walk this earth. Want to figure out how he got it in the first place? Stay tuned. Denis Mukwege was born 66 years ago, on March 1st in 1955, in Bukavu in the Republic Democratic of Congo, as the third child in a family of nine. And at birth, he almost died from an infection, which the Swedish Pentecostal saved him from. He grew up with a passion for medicine, wishing to heal the sick because his dad, who was a Pentecostal minister, often prayed for them. His passion became even larger after he witnessed the childbirth complications Congolese women often experienced due to lack of specialist healthcare. In 1983, he graduated from the University of Burgundy with a medical degree, serving as a pediatrician in the Lemera Hospital near Bukavu. He enjoyed his job working with kids, but he would nevertheless see female patients, constantly reminding him of how women after childbirth suffered from numerous problems. He finally decided to temporarily move to France, where he studied gynecology and obstetrics at the University of Angers, later obtaining a master's degree in 1989. He continued his work in the Lemera Hospital when his studies were completed. And from this point on, we will refer to him as Dr. Denis Mukwege. In 1996 to 1997, the drastic First Congo War took place. A civil war and international military conflict destabilizing the Democratic Republic of Congo, known as Zaire at the time, due to rebel groups, dictatorship, etc. Even after it ended, the Second Congo War preceded it from 1998 to 2003, which ended up being far worse with 5.4 million total deaths, making it the deadliest worldwide conflict since World War II. So, Congo was going through a lot, but Denis Mukwege didn't panic. While others saw hopelessness and despair, he saw an opportunity. Now, it sounds terrible, but keep watching and you'll understand and see why he became the 2018 Nobel Prize winner. After the First Congo War, Dr. Denis Mukwege was forced to return to Bukavu, where he found an institution in 1999, the Panzi Hospital. He noticed how the damaging of the woman's genitalia was being used as a weapon of war during the Congo Wars. Seeing all the poor innocent Congolese women being raped in drastic amounts made him devote his entire life to reconstructive surgery to help women who were victims of sexual violence in Congo, which he all did in his hospital. Ever since the Panzi Hospital was founded, it has treated over 82,000 patients with gynecological damage and trauma, in which around 60% of those injuries he treated were results of sexual violence. A good majority of Dr. Mukwege's patients, during the Congo Wars, were coming from conflict zones. The hospital was initially built to host only 120 beds, however, that number has increased to 350, two times more than the initial amount. The Panzi Hospital admits 410 patients per month and is currently running at maximum capacity. This guy's the Congolese woman Superman. All jokes aside, it's clear to say that his job isn't easy. He was and still is treating women who went through one of the most, if not the most traumatic experience a woman could ever suffer. Dr. Mukwege has even said that he's had patients walk in naked in the worst physical conditions possible. The First and Second Congo Wars were the worst thing to happen to the Congolese since the Rubber Terror, a Congolese genocide led by the Belgians and their king, King Leopold II, who killed as many as 10 million people. Dr. Mukwege's job is definitely not fun, but it brought him an unexplainable joy to help those victims every single day. His philanthropy and hard dedication started to pay off. In 2008, he received the United Nations Human Rights Prize and the Olof Palme Prize for his outstanding efforts in promoting peace. A year later, in 2009, he published a thorough analysis of the rape crisis in the Democratic Republic of Congo based on his own experience. In 2014, he accepted the European Parliament's Sakharov Prize for Freedom of Thought. Dr. Mukwege had such an impact on the Congolese people that a film documentary was made on him, and it is called The Man Who Mends Women, which can be watched on YouTube or Amazon Prime Video. Unfortunately, impacting change in such a currently problematic country, there are consequences. In October 2012, he somehow survived a major assassination where four armed men broke into his house and held his daughters hostage while waiting for him to come home. When he arrived, they shot and killed his security guard at the time, missing Dr. Mukwege because he immediately dropped to the ground.
I was so touched with how he did for me and how he tried to save me and lose his own life intending to save my life.
After this attempt, he had to go into exile in Europe, affecting the daily operations in the Panzi hospital. And in September 2020, he was placed under UN guard after receiving several death threats because he condemned the continuous killings of civilians in the Democratic Republic of Congo, as well as called for accountability for the violation and abusage of human rights. So now that we looked at his whole life and seen his major accomplishments in the Democratic Republic of Congo, it is no wonder that Dr. Denis Mukwege became the first Congolese to receive a Nobel Peace Prize. He was declared the 2018 Nobel Peace Prize winners alongside Nadia Murad. Despite the Panzi Hospital's support network, it is constantly in need of the services they provide and continually faces shortages of money, supplies, and resources to expand. If you have a bit of extra money to help Dr. Denis Mukwege, you can go to his site, themukwegefoundation.org, or click the first link in the description below. If you're greedy or broke or don't enjoy donating for some reason, you can sign a petition at his site to help fight justice for Congolese women victims of sexual violence. Dr. Denis Mukwege, current director and founder of the Panzi Hospital, has treated survivors of sexual violence for over a decade and has cared for thousands upon thousands of victims since he started. He isn't just a doctor, he's a hero.
And I think that it's only when we can shift the shame from victim to perpetrators, there I think that the change will start.
Baby's looking, she begging for wood.
We ain't never felt so good.
So money be touching the ceiling, we good.
We ain't gotta talk no more. Spend all my money on phone and car.
How about the jet that I hit his room?
I ain't never gonna see you soon.
Working hard till we see the moon. Only hanging out with all my goons.